We had started with exercise 7.1. We have discussed first seven questions, and I told you last time to try question number seven. So if you have done this question, let me know, or you want to do it with me even then. Like, I can do this question with you if you want. So I had actually discussed with you last time the concept of collinear and non-collinear points. So if I had to do this question, question number seven, I need to find out a point on x-axis. Ravneet is trying to call me. Is she having trouble connecting? So we have exercise 7.1, question number 7. You have to find point on x-axis which is equidistant from 2, minus 5 and minus 2, comma 9. So keeping in mind that the point we need to find is on x-axis. So we will let the point. So let the point be x, comma 0. Since the point is on x-axis, you want to ensure that ordinate will be 0, because the point is on x-axis. And let's name this point. That will be convenient for us. You can name it as whatever you want. I'm just naming it as S. And according to question, point S is equidistant from given two points. So let's name those points as well. So A is 2, minus 5, and B is minus 2, comma 9. And this will mean that SA is equal to SB. And then you can apply the distance formula. Sometimes you might also see that it has been written this way, and this step is written just to avoid the squares. Agar aap is step ke baad likhte ho, if you just write after this step, you have square root on this side and you have square root on this side. Under the square root, you will have the difference of abscissas squared plus the difference of ordinates squared on both the sides. But to avoid writing this, what you can do is, instead of using SA equals to SB, usko use karne ki bajaye kya kiya ja sakta hai, both distances can be squared. So we write this. So this is like squaring both sides without mentioning that these exist in roots. So aapko jaise convenient lagta hai. I'm going with the way I would normally do. So I'm just going to write down the values for SA and SB, and then I will see if I need to square or not. So applying the formula, the distance formula for SA, use S and A, the coordinates of S with A. So we will have x minus 2 whole squared plus 0 plus 5 whole squared. Now it's possible that you can do this without, like, you can just write directly the step that will appear after this. For example, yahan pe aap seedha 5 likh sakte ho. You don't have to write down 0 plus 5. That is completely fine by me. And then we need to take S with B. So we are taking S and B now. This will be X minus minus 2. So that will be X plus 2 whole square plus the difference of the ordinates. This will be 0 minus 9 whole square. And then we solve. And after this, you just have to solve. This will be X minus 2 whole square plus 5 squared is 25 equals to x plus 2 whole squared plus 9 squared is 81. Minus 9 squared is 81. And since there is a square root on both sides, I would like to simplify. I can square both sides. And it's not necessary that you have to show this. So after this, means the squaring part, jab aap root square likhoge, wo dikhana necessary nahi hai. So that would mean that the square roots will now be omitted. And after this, you can just solve and find out the value of x. You will get quadratic in x. I am actually having a sore throat, so it's actually difficult for me to speak. So I'm just going to solve this. If you have already solved, please let me know. You can actually unmute yourself and ask.
And we are solving.
Okay, you're solving side by side. Okay. So I have expanded the squares on both sides. Expanding the squares, you can see the term containing square is getting cancelled. 4 is also getting cancelled. So I will just transpose the terms. I'm getting 8x equals to, this will be negative 56. And x will be equal to minus 7. So according to this, the point is minus 7, 0. This is the answer. That's right, Tejwant. The answer is minus 7, 0. Remember, aapko batana hai point kaun sa hai. So hum point ki form mein answer denge, yahan mat chhod dena, x ki value nikalne ke baad. Anyone who wants to ask anything?
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, wo square root wala step skip bhi kar sakte hai, seedhe squaring both sides.
हाँ जी यहाँ पे इसके बाद आप सीधा ये लिख सकते हो.
ओके मैम.
इट्स नॉट नेसेसरी टू राइट डाउन स्क्वेयरिंग बोथ साइड्स. वैसे भी अगर देखा जाए अगर दोनों साइड्स पे रूट रूट है तो वो इट्स ओनली पॉसिबल इट्स लाइक रूट एक्स इज इक्वल टू रूट वाई. इट विल बी ओनली पॉसिबल इफ एक्स इज इक्वल टू वाई. अगर पावर्स इक्वल हैं तो बेसिस भी इक्वल होंगे. सो रूट इज एक्चुअली अ रैशनल पावर. एनीवन एल्स हु वुड लाइक टू आस्क एनीथिंग? आई होप यू हैव सॉल्व्ड. इफ यू आर राइटिंग डाउन प्लीज लेट मी नो. आई विल वेट. ओके. सो आफ्टर दिस वी हैव क्वेश्चन नंबर 8. So let's just take a look. Find the values of y for which the distance between these points is 10 units. Now you have two points E and Q and the distance between them is 10 units. Aapko distance diya hua hai, and if you look at the point Q, the coordinates of Q, the ordinate is missing here. So you will form an equation by writing down that PQ, this distance is 10. And you will solve the equation. So aapke paas root difference of abscissa squared plus the difference of ordinates squared, this will be equal to 10. Aap isko solve karoge. So I would like you to start and I will be doing it with you. So we have point P as 2, -3 and Q is given to me as 10, y, and according to question, the distance PQ is 10 units. So I'm just going to apply the distance formula here. Difference of the ordinates 2, -10 whole square, difference of the ordinates -3, -y whole square equals to 10. Now I'm going to square both sides here just to deal with the root on left hand side. So squaring both sides, I will get, this will be -8 squared, 64 plus, I'm expanding the square side by side. So this will be 9 plus y squared plus 6y equals to 100. यहां तक क्लियर हुआ? इसके बाद आपको सॉल्व करना है. This will be y square plus 6y minus, this is 73 minus 27. This is what you will get. And then this is a quadratic. You could use quadratic formula or you can try and factorize. This one's easy. This can be done by 9y minus 3y. So the factors that you will have are y plus 9 and y minus 3 equals to 0. From here, y plus 9 is equal to 0 or y minus 3 is equal to 0, which means y is either equal to minus 9 or y equals to 3. These are the two values. And now you can see question mein kaha gaya tha, find the values of y. Unhone pehle kaha tha, plural use kiya tha, that they are going to be more than one values. Anyone who would like to ask anything?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Ye jo aapke questions hain, ye isi tarah ke hain mostly. Tejwan beta, aapne mujhe last time pucha tha that the question where you have to find the relation or find out whether or not the points are collinear, you can do it with the formula for area of triangle. It's completely fine. I confirmed it with sir. So sir keh rahe the ke that formula does exist, but yeah, it's not in your syllabus because of this COVID situation. Otherwise, it will not be marked incorrect. So aap use kar sakte ho. All right. So now we are moving on to the next question. Yes.
First term में कौन कौन से chapters आने हैं?
बेटा first term में ma'am has sent the list, अभी मुझे ना देख के बताना पड़ेगा आपको. अभी तक हमने जितने chapters कर लिए हैं, we have done till now like seventh हम कर रहे हैं coordinate geometry. इसके बाद आपको coordinate geometry के बाद chapter 1, chapter 8 and chapter 9 trigonometry. हमें इतना काम और करना है अभी.
Okay, ma'am.
All right. So now question number 9th is also similar to the previous two questions. If Q, this point, is equidistant from P and R, what would this mean? Like if I had to simply write this, okay, this point ka distance P or R se equal hai. So this would mean that PQ equals to PR. This is what I have. And then I have to find the value of X. After you have the value of X, you have to find the distance QR and PR. Is the question clear?
Yes, ma'am.
All right. So let's just write this down. This is question number 9th of your exercise, and point Q, I'm just going to write down what's given to me. Point Q01 is Vansh Sharma. Yes, Vita.
Ma'am, PQ is equal to RQ नहीं होना चाहिए.
मैंने गलत लिख दिया. ओह यस, हाँ जी, मैंने यहाँ पे गलत मेंशन कर दिया था. पी क्यू एंड आर क्यू, दैट्स राइट, दैट्स राइट.
ओके मैम.
या सो वी हैव दीज टू पॉइंट्स, आर इज एक्स कॉमा सिक्स. सो दिस मींस द डिस्टेंस ऑफ पी फ्रॉम क्यू इज इक्वल टू डिस्टेंस ऑफ आर फ्रॉम क्यू, एंड दिस नाउ इज जस्ट लाइक क्वेश्चन नंबर 7. सो वी आर गोइंग टू just proceed to this if you want. This is what I was saying. अगर आप पहले यहाँ पे square लगा दोगे तो फिर roots नहीं आएंगे, तो आपके पास इस तरह से बनेगा on both sides. And if you want, you can write down the values in. Okay. If you want, you can write down the values in roots and then square or square later on, or you can square first and then just simply write this. अगर आप ये बीच वाला स्टेप नहीं लिखते, अगर आप ये वाला स्टेप नहीं लिखते, आपके पास स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ दिस एंड स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ दिस, दिस इज व्हाट यू विल हैव. तो आपको इसके बाद स्क्वेयरिंग करनी पड़ेगी. Otherwise, you can do the square before you write down the formula for the distance. You can write this if you want. So it's up to you. Whichever way you find it convenient to solve. So I'm just going to use the formula for this now. PQ. So this will be 5 minus 0 whole square plus minus 3 minus 1 whole square. And on right hand side, I will have x minus 0 whole square plus 6 minus 1 whole square. And then this will be 25 plus 16 equals to x square plus 25. And you can mention that square has been omitted by this squaring both sides. So usse phir ye aapka cancel ho jayega. And just solve. So from here, x square comes out to be 16, and the value of x is positive or negative 4. Any questions still here?
No, ma'am.
Once you have the values of x, you have been asked to find out the distances qr and pr. So, aapko qr or pr solve karna hai. So QR is this. This is QR. So you can use it here. X square plus 25. And then you have to find out PR. PR will require solving. This will be I'll just write down the values here. P is 5 comma minus 3 and R now is okay. It will be plus minus 4 comma 0. Is there anyone else who's having trouble reading from the screen?
No, ma'am.
Okay. Jasmine, beta, try to find a place jahan pe network aa raha ho. Or you can try to reconnect. Ek baar dobara connect karne ki koshish karo. Now, at this point, jab hamare paas hame PR solve karna hai, hamare paas R do points bante hain. One is with plus 4, 0, because x ki do values aayi hain. Just watch here, x. R was given to be x comma 6 or x ki values aayi hain plus minus 4. That means R can be written as 4 comma 6 or R can be written as minus 4 comma 6. Keeping this in mind, we have to find out the distance PR. Ab jab aapko PR nikalna hai, ek is se nikal sakta hai aur ek second option se nikal sakta hai. So you can solve both separately and give your answer. Or you can do it together. I don't think it will have any effect on your answer. Root shape, I think, farak nahi padta. Does it? Let's just use this positive. So you will have a 5 minus 4 whole square. Then plus, it will change. It will change to become addition. So then the other one will be minus 3 minus 6. Solve this, or PR will be equal to 5 plus 4 whole square plus minus 3 minus 6. So these are the two answers that you have. This is 1, this is 81. So solve this. This will be root 82. And the other one will be 81 plus 9 square. Have you solved this?
Root 162.
All right. Anyone with any questions?
No, ma'am.
All right. 9 root 2 under 41. Yes.
हम इनको आगे सिंपलीफाई नहीं करना.
If you want, you can. इसमें आपके पास फैक्टर्स बन के अगर सिंपलीफिकेशन होती आप कर दो. Or you could just leave your answer here. Root 82 units and root 162 units. If you want, you can go ahead. Simplify. Multiple choice में आएगा तो आपको करना पड़ेगा. वहाँ पे देखकर choices क्या क्या हैं उसके according आप आंसर करोगे. As for now, you could leave the answer as such, depending on the time you have or not. So 82, इसमें बनते हैं factors आपके 241. इसमें नहीं होंगे factors. I think इसमें बन जाते हैं आपके पास. Two root, no. दोनों में factors नहीं बनते. इसका आंसर आपके पास है x square plus 25. This will be plus minus 4 square plus 25. This will be under the root of 41. तो आपके पास ये answers बनते हैं. Okay. This will be 9 root 2. Thank you. The other two don't have pairs, I think. Is that right, Tejwant? And okay, two students have answered. Shaunak and Tejwant, thank you so much. This completes your question. Let's move on to the next question that we have. Question number 10th. Find a relation between x and y such that xy is equidistant from these two points. So if I had to just name these points, let's name this as A, this as B, this as C. So the condition that we're going to use is AB, the distance AB is equal to the distance AC. And again, you will have the distance formula applied on both sides. Since there is a point jisme aapke paas nahi axis hai, nahi coordinate hai, you're going to have an equation in X and Y. So you'll get an expression in X and Y, and that's what you have to find out. Relation means you will get an algebraic expression. Aapke paas ek algebraic expression aega. You will not be able to solve it completely. Now, a similar question is asked in a different way. They will say that these points are equidistant. I think it's last exercise. The optional exercise, if you want to take a look. Optional exercise, the question is shayad. Let me just quickly grab it. No, it's not there. I think it was in the assignment last time. So what they say is, they will say, prove that. So if this point is equidistant from these two, then the question will be to prove that. Aage aapke paas ek expression hoga. If I had to just look at the answer for this one, the answer for question number 10 is 3x plus y minus 5. Aapke paas ye aa jata hai, 3x plus y minus 5. Equals to zero. तो इस तरह से भी क्वेश्चन आ जाता है. Instead of asking you to find a relationship, they will say कि अगर ये पॉइंट है तो ये प्रूव करो. So that means अगर आप यहाँ पे सॉल्व करोगे, given question सॉल्व करोगे, this is what you're going to get. So this question can be asked in two ways. If I'm making sense to you, please let me know if it's clear. The two ways this question can be asked. All right. Let's write in the notebooks. So question number 10th, we have this point equidistant from these two. And the points are so this will mean the distance AB is equal to the distance AC, and now you're going to apply the formula for the distance between two points. So this will be x minus 3 whole square, y minus 6 whole square under the root. And on right hand side, you will have x plus 3 whole square plus y minus 4 whole square. And then we will solve x square plus 9 minus 6x. The terms with the squares will get cancelled. As you can see, you are left with terms only with x and y. 9 also gets cancelled. This should be x here. I've written wrong. This should be x. 6x. So you get 12x. I'm transposing all terms to right hand side. Plus six x, then we have plus 4y, and then taking the constants, we have a minus 20 equals to 0. This is what you will have, and from here you can take 4 common, and hence the relation. 3x plus 4y equals this minus 5 equals to 0. This is the required relation.
Mom?
Yes.
Mom, ye 12x ki jagah 12xy nahi tha?
Nahi beta. आपके पास किसी भी स्क्वायर में एक्स वाई इकट्ठे नहीं है. आपके पास एक्स वाई का प्रोडक्ट नहीं आएगा. जो आपके ब्रैकेट्स हैं अंडर द रूट, यहां से आपके पास जो प्रोडक्ट्स आएंगे, जब आप स्क्वायर अप्लाई करोगे, स्क्वायर आइडेंटिटी अप्लाई करोगे, आपके पास एक्स वाई का तो प्रोडक्ट कहीं पे भी नहीं आ रहा. इफ यू वॉन्ट आई कैन रीराइट दिस स्टेप. शुड आई?
नो मैम, एक्चुअली मैंने प्लस की जगह मल्टीप्लाई कर दिया था.
Okay.
Thank you, mom.
You're welcome, beta. Anyone else who would like to ask anything?
No, ma'am.
All right. If anyone's writing down, please let me know. Okay. So
yes, let's, ma'am.
Who's writing?
Just one step, ma'am.
Sure.
Done, ma'am.
So the next topic that we have is the section formula. Aapne jo first exercise ki thi, it was based on distance formula, and second exercise is based on section formula, and this actually helps us to find out the coordinates of a point which divides a given line segment in a fixed ratio. So if I had to just simply take a line segment. Let's just take a line segment here. So let us say we have a line segment, and we have n points marked as AB. So aapke paas, we have coordinates of A as x1, comma y1. These are the coordinates for A. And over here we have B, its coordinates are x2, comma y2. So these are the n points. And let us assume that on this line segment, there is a point, say P. And this point P divides your line segment AB. Earlier, AB yahan se yahan tak tha, from here to here, from point A to point B. Now, because of the point P that I have marked, this line segment is divided into two parts. Part AP, the line segment AP, a portion ye hai. और दूसरा पोर्शन है PB. सो दीज आर द टू पार्ट्स. एंड इफ आई हैव टू राइट डाउन द रेशियो ऑफ दीज टू पार्ट्स, लेट्स अज्यूम दैट द रेशियो ऑफ दीज टू पार्ट्स इज m इज टू n. आई एम नॉट श्योर, आई थिंक बुक में एम एल से किया हुआ है ना, या बुक में आपने एम वन एम टू यूज किया है. इफ यू वॉन्ट यू कैन यूज एम वन एम टू, आई एम यूजिंग एम एन एन. लेट्स जस्ट कीप इट अवे इन बुक, इट्स कन्वीनियंट फॉर यू टू रिमेम्बर. सो एम वन इज टू एम टू. इसका मीनिंग ये हुआ, सपोज आपके पास एक लाइन सेगमेंट है ए बी और उसके उसकी लेंथ है 10 यूनिट्स. सपोज द लेंथ इज 10 यूनिट्स एंड ऑन दिस पॉइंट आई हैव अ पॉइंट पी एंड द डिस्टेंस ए पी इज 4 यूनिट्स. द डिस्टेंस ऑफ पॉइंट पी फ्रॉम ए इज 4 यूनिट्स एंड ओवर हियर इज 6 यूनिट्स. देन वी कैन राइट डाउन द रेशियो ऑफ ए पी एंड पी बी एज 4:6. So on simplifying, this is the ratio that we get. So यहाँ पे M1 जो है वो 2 है और M2 3 है. तो यहाँ पे हम ये लेके चल रहे हैं कि हमें बताया हुआ है कि जब ये division हुई तो ratio क्या आई. Is this clear? Thank you, Sahej. Okay. So what we have, yeah. So this is what's given to us. हमें ratio बताई हुई है इन दोनों हिस्सों की. And I'll just mark that here. So I've got this part. M1 and this part is M2. और आपको इस तरह से शो किया होगा M1 is to M2. Using these, using the coordinates of point A, coordinates of point B, and the ratio in which point P divides the line segment, we can find out the coordinates for P. हम ये find कर सकते हैं. So that means there is a relation existing between coordinates of A and B, A ke coordinates, B ke coordinates, and the ratio with the coordinates of P. Char cheezein use ho rahi hain beta. At any given time, inme se kuch bhi missing ho sakta hai. The coordinates of A, coordinates of B, the ratio in which this point divides AB, and then finally the coordinates of P. The relation that we are going to write down actually helps us find out the coordinates of P. So x ke coordinates jab aapne likhne hain, you will start with the ratio and cross multiply sort of thing. So I will start with the ratio. I've got M1. I'm working with the abscissa here. Abscissa means aapne sirf x wali values pe focus karna hai. So M1 with x2 plus M2 with x1. And in the denominator, you will have M1 plus M2. And when you have to find out the ordinate, you are now going to work with the Y values. So once again, M1 with Y and M2 with Y. Cross multiply. So M1 Y2 plus M2 Y1. In the denominator, you have M1 plus M2. This is the formula that we have. तो अगर आपको बताना है पीके कोऑर्डिनेट्स क्या होंगे तो हम इस तरह से फाइंड कर सकते हैं. और इस फॉर्मूले में आपके पास आप देख सकते हो क्या क्या यूज हो रहा है. यू यूजिंग x1 y1, दीज आर द कोऑर्डिनेट्स ऑफ a. यू आर यूजिंग x2 y2, दोज आर द कोऑर्डिनेट्स ऑफ b. एंड यू आर यूजिंग m1 m2 व्हिच इज द रेशियो इन व्हिच p डिवाइड्स ab. इज इट क्लियर?
Yes, ma'am.
Anyone who would like to ask anything here? Sometimes यहाँ पे जो ratio दी हुई है M1 is to M2, इसको K is to 1 की form में भी लिखा जाता है. So that I will use in the questions where it's needed in particular. This form will be required in some questions in particular. And even if you do with M1, M2, that will be completely fine. You will come across some questions जहाँ पे K is to 1 use हुआ है, M1, M2 नहीं use हुआ. बट हम M1 M2 के साथ सारे सम्स कर सकते हैं. कंप्लीटली आपका आंसर आएगा. There will be no problem at all. Now, if P is the midpoint, now this is an observation which we could have from here. Section means division. So this is the division formula. Line segment gets divided into two parts. The ratio of those two parts is given, and the point which divides the line segment, its coordinates can be found using this formula. If P were the midpoint, just observe. If P were the midpoint, आपके पास line segment है A B, the end points coordinates are x1, y1 and x2, y2, and P is the midpoint. If P is the midpoint, what will happen? Can you say anything about the ratio in which We have AP and PB. This will be 1:1. Because both parts are equal, their ratio will be 1:1. That means M1 ki value bhi 1 ho jayegi, M2 ki value bhi 1 ho jayegi. And because of that, if we apply